Turning now to a resting place that's set to become the capital's newest tourist attraction. Willesden Jewish Cemetery is where a list of famous figures are buried, among them financiers, scientists, and the founder of a supermarket giant. Thomas McGill has been to visit the site to find out more.
And any idea the number of people buried here?
Nearly 27,000. Nearly 27,000.
And it all started with this man.
Samuel Moses, the first person to be buried in Willesden Cemetery.
Willesden Jewish Cemetery, the resting place for thousands of Jewish Londoners for generations.
He was buried in October 1873.
Since then, the great and the good of Jewish society has been laid to rest here, with many forward thinkers securing the best plots along its prestigious avenue. This is the funeral of Leopold de Rothschild in 1917, and he is now laid to rest here in this huge family plot, which is a real symbol of their wealth and influence. It's also extravagant, which is a real feature of this Victorian part of the cemetery.
In this, the heart of the Victorian cemetery, yes, you've got a great variety of monuments. I think they took great pride in the design of each of the individual monuments and memorials. But as you get closer to today, we start to see something much more conventional. So in the new ground, which is at the southern end of the cemetery, you'll see much more standardised headstone.
Among the graves here are many well-known Jewish figures like the chemist Rosalind Franklin and the movie director Michael Winner. But the vast majority are ordinary Londoners with their own extraordinary stories. People like Holly's family, who she discovered were buried here by chance.
So these are my great-great-grandparents and their son.
They were immigrants from Russia, and since finding their tombs here, Holly says she's done more research into her family tree.
They kind of started here with nothing, put down their roots, and all managed to make a great success of their lives. Betty, she lived until she was nearly 102, and she often told the story of how she saw her first electric light bulb as part of her kind of life. So it's been really fun to read about how much the world changed in their lifetimes.
Bosses now hope as London's newest tourist attraction, new visitors will help bring the cemetery and the stories of its inhabitants back to life for a new generation. Thomas McGill, BBC London.